And let's look at the neuronal control of the breathing. So the control center is in your pons and medulla oblongata. So the detail of this part was still not 100% understood what's going on. And the reason is it's difficult to measure their activity when they're still working. You put electrode in to measure their neuronal activity, and when you come to close, you kill those neurons, and the animal stop breathing, so you have to do it over. And you can put electrode here, you have to record them work simultaneously. It's very difficult to do that. So we are still not 100% understood. But we understand the general picture. We have the pons part, a medulla part. So medulla part is the one initiate respiration. So that's the key part. The pons parts, because they're closer to the higher brain area, so they modulate respiration. They receive the input from the higher brain center. Like your emotion can affect your pons, and from the pons control the medulla. And now let's look at the medulla. The medulla part, you have the dorsal, you have the ventral. So the dorsal part is the quiet breathing. The dorsal part is when you are sleeping. Okay, that's the main one. That's the main one, control your quiet breathing. And the ventral part is forced breathing. When you start to exercise, you use the ventral part to help. You use those accessory muscles like your rectus abdominis and other accessory muscles, internal intercostal. That's from the ventral part. And the dorsal part is the basic breathing. And also in the ventral part, you have the pre-Boehringer complex. These neurons, they are very similar to the pacemaker cells in the heart. They spontaneously fire. And when they spontaneously fire, pacemaker cells fire about 60 to 70 times per minute. And those pre-Boehringer complex, they fire about 12 to 14 times per minute. And when they fire, they provide the input to the dorsal part. They create the basic breathing rate. So when you go to sleep, you still breathe normally. And let's look at those sensor. The sensor, your body sends CO2, your body sends oxygen, your body also sends pH. And you have the peripheral sensor, you have the central sensor. Your peripheral sensor sends all three of them. And their location are very close to your baroreceptor in your blood. Those chemoreceptor in your carotid and aortic, aorta and carotid artery. They sense CO2 level. And they sense oxygen, they also sense pH. But you found the PO2 level, it need to drop to about 60 millimeter mercury and to trigger the response. So it's pretty bad to detect the oxygen. But every time your body oxygen level is low, your body CO2 level is high. And your body is very sensitive to the CO2 level. That's when you start to exercise. Your CO2 levels start to increase and your breathing rate start to increase. Your body is very sensitive to CO2. So it turned out it worked pretty well. And that's the peripheral sensor. Your central sensor only detect CO2. You won't be able to detect pH, won't be able to detect oxygen. The reason is for your central sensor in your medulla oblongata, this molecule need to come across blood-brain barrier. And that's the extra layer created by the glia cells to prevent toxic molecule and bacteria go to your brain. So it turned out only the CO2 can go through blood-brain barrier. It goes through blood-brain barrier, it will dissolve in the cerebrospinal fluid, and it will become carbonic acid and become the hydrogen and bicarb. And the oxygen can bind with the central sensor, and your central sensor sense the CO2. So based on all this, the big molecule decide your breathing rate is CO2. In your body is CO2. And your body is very sensitive to CO2. Both peripheral and central sensor can detect CO2. And that's when your CO2 levels start to increase. Your control center, medulla oblongata, can forcefully increase your breathing rate and sometimes hijack your power. Like we have the toddler will ask you, if you don't buy this candy to me, I'm gonna hold my breath to death. And turn out they could not do that. Because when you keep holding their breath and their CO2 levels start to increase, eventually you will reach the threshold and your RCC will take over and forcefully increase the ventilation so they can start to breathe.